This is TWiT.
Leo Laporte, the tech guy. 8888 Ask Leo, the phone number. Delois in Torrance, am I saying that right, Delois?
Yes, this is Delois.
Hi, Delois. How are you?
I'm well, and I absolutely love your show.
Well, I love you, Delois. Thank you for calling.
Thank you. Thank you for taking my call. Okay, so my concern is this. I have a Acer Chromebook, number 11.
How do you like that?
I love it. I actually love it. But
so when I tell people get a Chromebook, you're going, yeah, he's right.
Well, I would agree with that. But
good.
The problem that I am having is finding a printer that is compatible with this Chromebook. I do not print a lot, but when I want to print, I would love to have a printer. And the printer that I have is an Epson Stylus NX510 series. But when I hook it up, nothing comes out.
So Chromebooks don't have the drivers. You have to adjust your thinking a little bit as we enter the new age of computing. We used to be get a printer, you hook it up with a cable, and you print. Nah, can't do it with Chromebooks. The only printers that will do that is HP. They have a special HP extension for Chromebooks. What Google expects you to do is use a service called Google Cloud Print. In order for this to work, you need to have a printer that supports Google Cloud Print. Probably your Epson does. As far as I know, all the Epsons do. And then you need to set it up through your Google account. And so you'll say what kind of printer you have. And then what it does is it prints wirelessly. But both your printer and your Chromebook have to be online. They don't have to be on the same network. So you can print at home from the road even.
Okay.
So look into setting up Google Cloud Print on your printer. Do you have Wi-Fi at home?
I do.
Okay. As long as that printer supports Wi-Fi, and almost all modern printers do, you should be good. Of course, remember, you can always print at a print service. If you don't print very often, you can print at Kinko's or somewhere like that, set up an account with them, and then it'll just print to them. Cloud Print is really interesting because the idea is you can print to any printer that, you know, you've set up anywhere in the world.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, wait a minute. I have one more question.
Sure, of course.
I have, I'm having problems with my television accepting my DVD. I set the DVD up, which I think is right. The connections are all right. I have the red with the red and the yellow with the yellow and the white with the white.
Yeah.
But I can get a sound on the TV, but I don't get a picture.
Yeah. So most DVDs, you want to not use the red, yellow, and white cables, but you want to use HDMI if you can. The DVD player probably has HDMI out. Does your TV have HDMI in? Do you know what the HDMI cable looks like?
Yes, I do. My TV does because my TV is only a year old.
Modern TVs all do. That's the standard. But maybe your DVD player is older and it doesn't.
Yeah, because the DVD player is like 6 years old, so maybe
it should have HDMI. What you're using is really the worst possible way to play back a DVD. It's the old composite video format, and that was what VHS, you know, VCR recorders used. So it's not very good quality. Your DVD is capable of better quality than that. So usually we want to use a digital connection, and those digital connections, there's two kinds. The most prevalent is HDMI. That's what everything uses now. And then there is something called component, which has red, green, and yellow cables. But those are just video. Those don't do audio. So
okay.
HDMI, look on the back of your DVD player. Now, I have to say, if it doesn't have HDMI, you can get a new DVD player for under $50. They're cheap.
Right.
That
okay.
will. Yeah.
Will do.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Oh, I can't imagine anybody make a DVD player that didn't have an HDMI port, but maybe many moons ago. Is it red, green, and blue? Is that what component is? That makes sense. RGB, yeah. Isn't there a yellow? No, the yellow, that's right. Yellow is the composite. So she was hooking up the old yellow composite connection, and then the red and white is left and right audio. Stereo audio. So that is a pretty old-fashioned way of doing it. I'm not surprised she's not getting a picture. In fact, the TV probably is. What is this? What are you sending me? I don't recognize that.